While there were already many rumors about the release of iOS 15, with WWDC 21 Invitation published, things went even more intense of what we can expect. Let's talk about the most important Apple operating system, and let's make a summary of everything that we know, or at least we think we do, about the next-gen iPhone. Hi guys, and welcome to Digital Marketing Channel. My name is Marco, and this is your dose of Apple news, leaked information, rumors and opinions. Make sure you subscribe, leave a comment below, hit the like button and enable all notifications so you don't miss the next video. Friends, if you ever wanted a good website, a blog, a social network, a web store and everything with elite class hosting, look no further than my buddies from Ireland, Blackbeard Hosting. Simple, easy to use website installer, 24/7 customer support, real people and more, hosted on fast, reliable and secure servers. Hey, even VPN is included. Check it out, 1 month free trial, no credit card needed. The link is in the description and in the comment. With Digital Marketing's code, you get 5% off. Blackbeard Hosting, hosting as it should be. The introduction of the next iteration of iPhone OS is almost around the corner, and as it appears, we already have some potential big revelations. Let's start with that elite control center redesign. If predictions are true, we should not be surprised if it receives look and feel of the Big Sur. Let me be honest with you, in its current state, it is a big pile of crabs, not easily accessible with smaller hands and left with a lot to be desired. To be short, it's not the best. Sadly, I'm not a big fan of macOS approach either. But then let's see how it turns out on the iPhone. At least I hope they will reinvent how we are accessing it, because I would prefer, as many others that I've seen, that we can simply access it from the bottom of the display instead of from top. I would personally like to see option to edit it, remove and rearrange icons, and if necessary, to organize them in groups and everything within the control center, instead of going to settings, which really doesn't make sense. Since we are talking about macOS Visual Touch, we've seen on multiple places that all the icons will get similar treatment. The rumor has it we are heading toward a new morphism in terms of design. I have to admit, I'm a little bit bored with flat design, but I'm not a big fan of all identical icon shapes either. Because in this case, it looks like you'll be staring at MIUI. Recent leaks by Mako Takara showcased the new iPhone dummy with a smaller notch. I was hoping to see it thinner, instead seems like we're getting the smaller one, which is... Excuse me. With that in mind, we may be able to see more on the top, including the battery percentage, earphones connections, and so on. However, one of the most anticipated features that will come with the next-gen iPhones are LPTO displays. It will be around 15 to 20% more power efficient. We will get to see always-on display for the first time ever on the iPhones. Please don't exclude that as an option, because initially I could hear people saying iPhone or iOS doesn't need customization, but when widgets and icons changes became possible, many users went nuts. In the release Apple's display roadmap, as I posted in my community section, there are actually two display refresh options. One is 120Hz, which is something that we were expecting, and the other one is 90Hz. I don't recall seeing anyone talking about it, but I'm curious to see, is there any possibility that non-pro editions indeed get better refresh rate as well, at least in a close future? Keep in mind, this same roadmap revealed a punch hole design, although for 2021, it may not be very accurate. This same document shows that this year we will see return of the Touch ID, but not under the display. Things may have changed though. And now, punch hole design that I mentioned, and for for example Touch ID inside of the power button, indeed belong to the next generation of iPhone SE, which is now predicted for 2022. So will there be under the display fingerprint sensor with this year's iPhones? Possible. In any case, having iOS 15 capable to support dual biometric authentication means more security and less rigid way to unlock your iPhones. That would be all. Hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to subscribe, hit the thumbs up and turn on notifications. Make sure you check offers in the description. Occasionally, there are Apple products and accessories. Thank you so much for watching Digital Marketing Channel. My name is Marco. Talk to you soon. Have an excellent day. Bye. CyberGhost VPN. Surf fast, stream anything, face no limits, hide your IP and stay secured. Up to 83% of discount with extra 3 months for free. CyberGhost VPN.